everyone. Hope all of you and your family are fine during this COVID-19 pandemic situation. As you all know, children, we have provided you with a new passing package material which contains short questions. Out of which, definitely you are going to score above 30 out of 70. Today, we are here to explain you each and every question so that it becomes so easier for you to prepare for your final board exam. Now, let me start from the chapter 1, that is solid state. And here, if you consider the passing package material, according to the blueprint, if you consider, the first chapter, that is solid state, has got the weightage of around 7 marks, out of which one two mark question will be shortly appearing from part B, and 1 5-mark question will be appearing from part D. And next, let us move towards the chapter, that is solid state. Firstly, if you consider the first question, give any two differences between crystalline solids and amorphous solids. Here, if you consider the crystalline solids as well as amorphous solids, under which it comes, you might be thinking of this. Children, as you all know that the matter is that which has mass and occupies space, that is regarded as matter. And physically, the matter has been classified into 3 types. One is the solid state, liquid state, and finally, the gaseous state. If you consider the solid state substances have got its own characteristic properties. The particles are orderly arranged such that the interparticle distances are short and the interparticle force of attraction will be more, such that they will give the solids a definite geometrical shape and definite volume. And the solids are further classified into 2 types. One is the crystalline solid. The other one is the amorphous solid. Crystalline solids have got definite geometrical shape. Every crystalline solid has got its own shape, which is of a definite geometrical shape. And the crystalline solids are going to have a sharp melting point. They are going to melt at a sharp temperature. And if you consider the crystalline solids, they are anisotropic in nature. You might be thinking of what is anisotropy. Anisotropy means the physical properties of the solids like refractive index and thermal conductivity. If you measure those properties at different angles, they are going to show you the same values even though if you are going to measure at different angles. That property of the solids is regarded as anisotropy. And here if you consider the crystalline solids, they have got definite geometrical shape, sharp melting point, and they are anisotropic in nature. And if you consider the amorphous solids do not have a definite geometrical shape that can be regarded as they have got irregular shape because there is no orderly arrangement of the particles in the case of amorphous solids. And the amorphous solids are going to melt over a range of temperature. That is, the amorphous solids do not have a short melting point. They are going to have a range of melting points. And the amorphous solids are isotropic in nature. When you are going to measure the properties of the solids like refractive index and thermal conductivity and all, those properties are going to have different values when they are measured at different angles. Hope you got to know about the first question. The question is regarding the differences between crystalline solids as well as amorphous solids. These are the points of differences between those two. And now let us move towards the next question, children. The next question is regarding calculate the number of particles present per unit cell in a simple cubic unit cell. Whenever you are going to consider a cube, The cube has got 8 corners, as you all know, and there are 8 lattice points at each corner. Each corner will be having 1 lattice point. So totally, the simple cube will be containing 8 corner particles. And if you consider the contribution of each particle, the contribution per unit cell of each particle will be 1/8 times. Hope you could able to see here. It is 1/8 times. So totally how many corner particles are there? 8 corner particles are there. So the number of particles present per unit cell in a simple cubic unit cell will be 1. You got to know about the answer. Now let us move towards the next problem, that is the third question. Regarding calculate the number of particles present per unit cell in a body-centered cubic unit cell. And if you consider the body-centered cubic unit cell, along with the corner particles, there is a presence of 1 particle at the center of the cube. And as you all know that the contribution of each corner particle will be 1/8 times. 1/8 times adu contribute madutte. So totally corner particles eshti ide? 8 corner particles ide. But if you consider the particle which is present at the center of the body, it is not shared by any other crystal system. So its contribution per unit cell will be 1 itself. Totally, if you calculate the number of particles present per unit cell, in case of BCC, the number of particles present will be 2. Okay. And now, children, let us move towards the next question. The next question is regarding calculating the number of particles present per unit cell in face-centered cubic unit cell. If you consider a FCC unit cell, even here in the case of FCC, there is a presence of 8 corner particles. Along with that, as you all know that a cube will be containing 6 faces and each face will be containing 1 particle. And that particle can be shared by 2 other crystals. So the contribution of a face-centered particle will be 1/2 times. You can consider, hope you could able to see here, it is 1/2 times. As I already told you, there are 6 faces, so at each center, at the center of each face, there will be 1 particle. So how many face centered particles will be present? 6 face centered particles will be present, and its contribution will be 1/2 times. So that if you totally calculate the number of particles present in a face-centered cubic unit cell, it is going to be 4. Hope you got to know regarding the number of particles present in the case of simple cubic unit cell, body-centered cubic unit cell, as well as face-centered cubic unit cell. If you consider the simple cubic unit cell, it has got 1 particle. If you consider the body-centered cubic unit cell, it has got 2 particles. And if you consider the face-centered cubic unit cell, it has got 4 particles. Now, children, let us move towards the next question. The fifth question is regarding what is meant by the term coordination number in solids. And further, the question continues. What is the coordination number in a face-centered cubic close packing structure? Before stepping into the question, children, one thing you need to understand, what is coordination number? Coordination number means the number of nearest neighbors of a particular particle, that is regarded as the coordination number. Suppose, children, let me draw and show you that. Suppose if you have a sphere here, when the particle is there, the number of nearest particles like this, when the particle is nearest particles present, those nearest neighbors of a particle is regarded as coordination number. Hope you got to know about what is coordination number. And now let me tell you, what is the coordination number in a case of face-centered cubic close packing structure. Here in the case of FCC, the coordination number is 12 because a particle is in contact with other 12 particles, so that the coordination number in the case of FCC will be 12. Now, children, let us move towards the next question. The next question is regarding the voids. Voids, but if you see the sixth question says that in a close-packed array of n spheres, how many octahedral and tetrahedral voids are present? Before stepping towards octahedral and tetrahedral, you must know what is void. Void, Andre, you know. Void means the unoccupied space in the crystal system, that is known as void. And if you consider the void, there are two types of voids. One is the octahedral void, the other one is the tetrahedral void. If you consider the octahedral void, the coordination number in the case of octahedral void is 6, and in the case of tetrahedral void, it is 4. And the question is regarding a close-packed array contains n number of spheres. It is saying you that the close-packed structure contains n number of spheres. N number of spheres only arranged are there. If such is the condition, how many octahedral and how many tetrahedral voids are present in that? One thing you need to know here, children, the octahedral voids will be equal to the number of spheres. Yester spheres irutto adike octahedral voids kuda equal irutte. But if you consider the tetrahedral void, the tetrahedral voids will be double the number of spheres. Yester number of spheres irutto adikinta double tetrahedral voids irutte. And here if you consider this problem, they are asking you that how many tetrahedral and octahedral voids are present if a close packed array contains n number of spheres. And here the number of octahedral voids will be n because the number of spheres present in an array is also n. And the number of tetrahedral voids will be equal to 2n because the number of tetrahedral voids will be double the number of spheres. Hope you got to know about the sixth question, children. Now let us move towards the next question. The seventh question is regarding what is packing efficiency in a crystal? Calculate the packing efficiency in a simple cubic unit cell. Packing efficiency, Andre Makla, here, it is the total space filled by the particles in a crystal is regarded as the packing efficiency. Andre, if you consider a crystal, when the crystal system na neevu consider martira andre alli eshtu percentage of space inna particles fill maadirutte adanna navu packing efficiency anta karitivi. Hagadre left out space na yen anta karibodu? You might be thinking of left out space. Now, Maklan, I already nimge helte, the unoccupied space in the crystal system is regarded as the void. Enella left out space avan the crystal system alli irutto adana navu void anta mention martivi. And here they are asking you the question, calculate the packing efficiency in a simple cubic unit cell. Simple cubic lattice alli packing efficiency eshtu ide anta neevu calculate madbekagutte. Here you could able to see the picture, I hope, children. There is a cube. Neevu cube na consider maradre makla, the edge lengths of the cube will be equal. Andre here it has got 8 edges, now 8 edges galu illi ide. If you consider totally all the edges, the edge length of cube will be equal. Ella edge length galu kuda ondukkondu equal aagi irutte. And here the angles, if you consider all the angles, will be equal to 90 degree, right angle ige equal irutte. And as I already mentioned you that if you consider a cube, the cube has got 8 corners, ನೀವು ಕೂಡ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ 8 ಕಾರ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಎಂದು ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಟೋಟಲಿ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡ್ರಾನ್ 3, ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ 4, ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಒನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ 6th ಒನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ 7th ಒನ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಟೋಟಲಿ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ 8. ಟೋಟಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಕಾರ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ? 8 ಕಾರ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಆ 8 ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಅಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದೊಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ದೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಅಟ್ ಈಚ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ by taking the particle, two corner particles as the center, they have drawn two spheres. ಎರಡು ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಎರಡು ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದ ಎ ಆಸ್ ದ ಎಡ್ಜ್ ಲೆಂತ್. ಏನ ನಾವು ಎಡ್ಜ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಗಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿ ದ ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ರೇಡಿಯಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಅಂತ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಲುಕ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಪಿಕ್ಚರ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ನೋ ದಟ್ ದ ಎ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಎ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 2r, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ 1r ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳ, ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ 1r ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ 2r, ಎ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 2r. ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾಥಮೆಟಿಕಲಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್, ದ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ 4/3πr³. ಈಗ ಒಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ನ ನೀವು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ದ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರಿಕಲ್ ಶೇಪ್. ಆ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ದ ಸ್ಪರಿಕಲ್ ಶೇಪ್ ಆ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದಾದ್ರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್, ದ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ 4/3πr³. ನೌ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬಿಕ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಸೆಲ್. ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೆಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬಿಕ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ದ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ಒನ್, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಒನ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ದ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಸ್ಪಿಯರ್ ಬೈ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಸೇಮ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ 4/3πr³. Now let us consider the volume of the unit cell. Here, what is a unit cell? The unit cell is a cube. Cube na consider madidivi. If you consider a cube, what is the volume of the cube? The volume of the cube will be a cube agirutte. Then what is a? We came to know that a is equal to 2r. Then a cube madidaga makla 2r whole cube martira, such that you are going to get the volume of the unit cell as 8r³. Okay, and further children, if you consider the packing efficiency, you know the formula of packing efficiency. For calculating the percentage of packing efficiency in any of the crystal, here the volume of the sphere divided by the volume of the unit cell multiplied by 100 will get you the percentage of packing efficiency. From the above data, you came to know that the volume of the sphere is 4/3πr³. And from the above data, you also came to know that the volume of the unit cell is 8r³. So you have substituted that value here. And you are, since you are finding out the percentage of packing efficiency, you are going to multiply by 100. So when you are going to calculate this, you are going to have the percentage of packing efficiency in the case of simple cubic unit cell as 52%. Then you might be thinking of what is a void that is present in the case of simple cubic unit cell. Here, if you consider the simple cubic lattice, the void, the percentage of void will be 48%. Hope you got to know about the calculating the packing efficiency in the case of a simple cubic lattice. Now children, let us head towards the next question. The next question is regarding calculate the packing efficiency in cubic closed packing. ಕ್ಯೂಬಿಕ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಮಕ್ಕಳ, ಅದರ್ವೈಸ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬಿಕ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ ಕರಿಬಹುದು. ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಬಿ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೆಕ್ಸಗನಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್. ಒನ್ ಕ್ಲೋ ಕ್ಯೂಬಿಕ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ವೇಸ್, ಲೈಕ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಸೆಂಟರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬಿಕ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ ಕರಿಬಹುದು, ಹೆಕ್ಸಗನಲ್ ಕ್ಲೋಸ್ ಪ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ ಕರಿಬಹುದು. ಹಿಯರ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಯು ಅ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸೆಂಟೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಎಫಿಷಿಯನ್ಸಿ ಇನ್ ಸಿಸಿಪಿ ಆರ್ ಎಫ್ಸಿಸಿ ಆರ್ ಹೆಚ್ಸಿಪಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಕುಡ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ ದ ಡಯಾಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ಡ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್, ಒಂದು ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಐ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಯು ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 8 ಕಾರ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್, 8 ಕಾರ್ನರ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಈಚ್ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್. Along with the corner particles, the FCC has also got one particle at the center of each face. Every face do centrally, there is a presence of one particle. And here we have drawn one diagonal, that is AC anna ondu diagonal la navilli draw madidivi. And that diagonal has got three particles. Hope you could able to see here. More particles will be present here. By taking that as the center, that in the center agi ikkondo makla, we can draw three spheres here. More spheres na navi tara draw madabodu. And know one thing children, here we know what is AD. AD and Renu anta namaku gottide, because AD is a edge length. And that will be equal to A. A ge equal irutte. Then what is BC? DC will also be equal to A ಗೆ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈವನ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಎಡ್ಜ್ ಲೆಂತ್. ಓಕೆ, ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಎ ಸಿ, ವಿ ಡೂ ನಾಟ್ ನೋ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಿ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಫೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಪ್ಯಾಕಿಂಗ್ ಎಫಿಷಿಯನ್ಸಿ, ವಿ ನೀಡ್ ಟು ನೋ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಎ ಸಿ. ಎ ಸಿ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್, ಹಿಯರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಒನ್ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ABC ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ರೈಟ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ಡ್ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್. ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ಡ್ ಟ್ರಯಾಂಗಲ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಪ್ಲೈ ದ ಪೈಥಾಗರಸ್ ಥಿಯರಮ್. ಪೈಥಾಗರಸ್ ಥಿಯರಮ್ ನ ನೀವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ. ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪೈಥಾಗರಸ್ ಥಿಯರಮ್, ವಿ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಎ ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎ ಬಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್ ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಬಿ ಸಿ ಸ್ಕ್ವೇರ್. And AC square will be equal to, what is AB? AB is equal to A, so it becomes A square. Then what is DC? DC is also equal to A, that is also becomes A square. Totally, if you do that, AC square will be equal to 2A square. And then what is AC? Ikkade square iradanna you are going to move to this side. Ikkade right hand side ge adanna move martira. Move maradaga matla, the AC will be equal to root 2A. But from the diagram, we came to know that AC is also equal to 4R. Henge 4R aitu anta neevu kelabodu. Here there is 1R, here there is the second R, from here to here there is the third R, and from here to here there is fourth R. R plus R plus R plus R will become AC is equal to 4R. Therefore, 4R will be equal to root 2A, such that A will be equal to 2 root 2R. Okay, now let us consider the volume of the unit cell. As you all know that even here we are considering the cubic system. The volume of the cubic unit cell will be A cube. What is A? We came to know from here that A is equal to 2 root 2 R, such that A cube will be equal to 2 root 2 R whole cube agutte. Then what is the volume of sphere? Volume of a single sphere will be 4/3 pi R cube. And as you all know that if you consider the FCC, face-centered cubic lattice, na neevu consider madidre, the number of particles present in a FCC unit cell will be 4. Because of that, we are going to multiply the volume of this sphere by number of particles such that you are going to get the volume of the spheres as 16/3. Pi r cube. And as you all know that for finding out the percentage of packing efficiency, we have got one formula, that is volume occupied by the sphere divided by volume occupied by the unit cell multiplied by 100. When you are going to substitute the volume of the sphere as well as the volume of the cube and multiply that by 100, you are going to get the percentage of packing efficiency. In the case of FCC, it is found to be 74%. 74% is the packing efficiency there in the case of face-centered cubic unit cell. And this face-centered cubic lattice can also be called as cubic close packing, and it also can be regarded as hexagonal close packed cubic lattice. Then what is the percentage of void in the case of FCC? If you consider the percentage of void in the case of FCC, it is found to be 26% as to unoccupied space there in the case of FCC. Now, hope you got to know about the how to calculate the packing efficiency in the case of FCC. Now, let us move towards the next question, children, that is regarding calculate the packing efficiency in body-centered cubic lattice. Body-centered cubic lattice, the diagram na neevu consider madidre makla, as I already told you that na nimge agle heliro hange, there are 8 corners irutte cube alli, and if you consider this 8 corners, prati vandu corner allu kuda ondu particle illi present irutte. Hope you could able to see. ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ನ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡಿ ಡಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ಟು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಟೋಟಲಿ 8 corners ಇದೆ. ಸೊ 8 particles ಅಂದ್ರೆ 1 particle ಆ 1 corner, ಟೋಟಲಿ 8 particles ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅಲಾಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್, ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಸೆಂಟರ್ಡ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬಿಕ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಂಟೇನ್ಸ್ 1 particle ವಿತ್ಇನ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್. ಆ ಒಂದು ಬಾಡಿದು ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ದು ಬಾಡಿನ ನೀವು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳ, ಅದರಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ 1 particle ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಶೇರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಎನಿ ಅದರ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್. ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ಬೇರೆ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅದು ಶೇರ್ ಆಗಿರಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಅಲೋನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಬೈ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಸೆಂಟರ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಅ ಡಯಾಗನಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಕುಡ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸಿ, ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಡಯಾಗನಲ್ ನ ನಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. ಬೈ ಟೇಕನ್ this particle as well as the center particle, a muru particle na consider maadi na innondu line na draw maartivi, we could able to draw a line here. Okay, and we do not know the length of this, idrudu length namage gottilla, but we know the length of AD do length namage gottide, that is edge length, that is equal to edge length, that is nothing but A. And we also know that ED do length kuda namage gottide, that is also equal to A. But this is not going to form a triangle, illi yavade triangle na form aagta illa andaga makla, firstly we are going to consider the triangle. This is the triangle we are going to consider, the triangle EFD na first naavu consider maartivi. After that iga EFD alli makla namge F idu edge length enu anta gottide, ED idu edge length enu anta gottide. By knowing this data we can find out this length, the length of EFD na naavu find out maartkontivi. After knowing the length of FD, we can consider this triangle. Triangle AFD na naavu consider maartivi. AFD na consider maartaga from the triangle EFD namge idrudu length gottagutte, and from the cube itself we came to know the edge length of AD ಇದು edge length ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಿದೆ. ಇದೆರಡು ಡೇಟಾಸ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಇತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಬೈ ಅಪ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪೈಥಾಗರಸ್ ಥಿಯರಮ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ಔಟ್ ದ ಇಎಫ್. EF the epsilon eno and then now find out markodu. Now let us consider, let A be the edge length of a cube and R be the radius of the sphere. And from the triangle EFD triangle na neevu consider madidre, when you are going to apply the Pythagoras theorem here, when we are going to apply the Pythagoras theorem, if a triangle is a right angled triangle agittu anta helidre, there we can apply the Pythagoras theorem. According to Pythagoras theorem, FD square will be equal to EF square plus ED square, and FD square will be equal to what is ED? EF in EF is equal to A. What is ED? ED is also equal to A, so that EF square will become A square and ED square will also become A square. So FD square will be equal to 2A square. Okay, then FD will be equal to root 2A. From the, now we are going to consider the next triangle, that is AFD. AFD triangle na now consider martivi. Here also we are going to apply the Pythagoras theorem, children, such that AF square will be equal to AD square plus FD square. So AF square will be equal to A square. What is AD? From the diagram we came to know that AD is equal to A. Then what is FD? FD we have calculated from the above data. Even though triangle na now consider maadi, FD na now find out maadi divi. As I already told you that FD square is equal to 2A square, that we are going to apply here, such that AF square will be equal to 3A square. AF will be equal to root 3A. And if we just look at the diagram, the AF is also equal to 4R ge equal irutte nan already helde. Illinda illige neevu length anna consider madidre makla, that is equal to 4R, because ilva center of one sphere inda edge ge navu distance anna consider madidre, that is equal to R. And from here to here also it is R. From here to here also it is R. So totally if you consider AF will be equal to 4R. 4R ke equal irutte. Therefore, 4R will be equal to root 3A. Then A will become 4R by root 3. And as you all know that here also we are going, since we are calculating the percentage of packing efficiency, here we are going to apply the formula. What is the formula? The percentage of packing efficiency is equal to volume occupied by the sphere divided by volume of the unit cell multiplied by 100. And what is the volume of the unit cell? Volume of the unit cell is A cube. What is A? From this data, we came to know that A is equal to 4R by root 3. And if we apply that here, volume of the unit cell will be equal to 4R by root 3 whole cube agate. And then what is the volume of the sphere? Volume of one sphere will be equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. But if you consider the body centered cubic lattice, the number of particles present in a body centered cubic lattice will be 2, such that you are going to multiply the volume of the each sphere by the number of particles, such that the volume of the spheres will become 8 by 3 pi r cube. When you are going to apply this data in the formula, you are going to have the percentage of packing efficiency in the case of BCC as 68%. Andre, the total space in the total percentage of space in the body centered cubic lattice will be covered by the particles, that is 68%. 68% is the space of particles in the fill agirutte. body centered cubic lattice at B. Then how much unoccupied space is present in BCC? If you consider that the BCC contains 32% of void, 32% of unoccupied space is present in the case of body centered cubic lattice. Hope you got to know about even this question, children. Let us further move towards the next question. That is the 10th question. The 10th question is regarding, give any two differences between Schottky and Frenkel defect. Defects and read makla, defects and the constant, no solid substances will be having a perfect arrangement. Perfect arrangement, yaude mandu solid allo iralla. The solids have got certain defects in them. Adalli kelavondu defects idde irutte. And if you consider that defect, there are certain types of defects, a large number of defects are present. Among that, children, the important thing are, one is a Schottky defect, the other one is a Frenkel defect. One is Schottky defect idde, innondu Frenkel defect idde. What is Schottky defect? Schottky defect henge arise agutte anta heladaga, if you consider a crystal system, when the crystal system na consider madidre, equal number of cations and anions will be missing from the lattice points. Adu the lattice sites in the equal number of cations matte equal number of anions miss aadaga, they are going to give place for this Schottky defect. ಓಕೆ, ಈಗ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಒಂದು ಕೇಟಲಾನ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಏನಯಾನ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಎರಡು ಕೇಟಲಾನ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ ಎರಡು ಕೇಟಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಕೂಡ ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ವೆನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೇಟಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಏನಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಮಿಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸ್ಕಾಟ್ಕಿ ಡಿಫೆಕ್ಟ್. ಆಗ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ವೆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಕಾಟ್ಕಿ ಡಿಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಸ್ಕಾಟ್, ಆಸ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಮಾಸ್ ಬೈ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್. ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ, ಯು ಆಲ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು, ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಯು ಬೈ ದಟ್ ಡ್ರಾಯಿಂಗ್. ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ವಾಟ್? ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು mass by volume. Mass by volume anta nimge gottide. This indicates you that density is directly proportional to the mass and the density is inversely proportional to the volume. Iga mass avandu solid do mass jaasti agutte andre obviously the density will also going to increase. Density kuda jaasti agutte yavaga avandu crystal system do mass kammi agutto aga density kuda ಕಮ್ಮಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಕಾಟ್ಕಿ ಡಿಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅರೈಸಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಮಿಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೇಟಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇನಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ? ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಾಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೇಟಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಇನಯಾನ್ಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ದ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್, ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ವೆನ್ ದ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ದ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ crystal is also going to decrease. If you consider this Schottky defect, the density of the crystal decreases. These are the points under the Schottky defect. And what is Frenkel defect? Frenkel defect andre eno? Frenkel defect hege arise agutte, how the Frenkel defect arises anta heladadre, here in the case of Frenkel defect there is a displacement, we can also consider dislocation of cation from their lattice site to the interstitial site. Whenever you are going to consider a crystal system, children, there is a presence of lattice points as well as interstitial site. Interstitial site kuda present irutte, lattice points kuda present irutte. But in the case of Frenkel defect, there arises dislocation of a cation. Cation will be dislocated from its normal site to the interstitial site. ಅದು ತನ್ನ ಜಾಗನ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಇಂಟರ್ಸ್ಟಿಷಿಯಲ್ ಸೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಕೂರುತ್ತೆ. ಸಚ್ ದಟ್ ಆ ಒಂದು ಕೇಸ್ ಅರೈಸ್ ಆದಾಗ ಸಚ್ ಡಿಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರಿಗಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಆಸ್ Frenkel defect. ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು Frenkel defect ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ವೆನ್ ದ ಫ್ರೆಂಕಲ್ ಡಿಫೆಕ್ಟ್ ಅರೈಸಸ್, ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ? ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್. as you all know that density is equal to mass by volume. Density is directly proportional to mass. Yavaga mass increase agutho, density kuda increase agutte. Yavaga mass decrease agutho, density kuda decrease agutte. But illi en aagta ide, in the case of Frenkel defect, there is no change in the mass because the cations are missing from their lattice point. But they are found in the interstitial site. ಇಂಟರ್ಸ್ಟೀಷಿಯಲ್ ಸೈಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಒಳಗೇನೆ ಇದೆ ಬಟ್ ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಸೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಂಟರ್ಸ್ಟೀಷಿಯಲ್ ಸೈಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದೆ ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ದ ಮಾಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಯಾವುದೇ ತರದಲ್ಲೂ ಮಾಸ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಮಾಸ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದಾಗ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಫ್ರಾಂಕೆಲ್ ಡಿಫೆಕ್ಟ್ Here, if there is a question regarding the differences between the Frenkel defect as well as Schottky defect, you can say that the Schottky defect arises due to the missing of equal number of cations and anions from their lattice point. And the density is going to decrease in the case of Schottky defect. And whenever you are going to consider the Frenkel defect, there is a dislocation of cation from the normal lattice to the interstitial site such that there is no change in the density. The density is going to remain as such. Now you can note one more thing here. There is one ionic crystal that is silver bromide, which has a special property to show both Schottky defect as well as Frenkel defect. Now let us move towards the next question, children. The next question is regarding solving a problem on density. And you need to have a formula here. And as you all know that density is equal to Z into M divided by A cube into NA. A cube into NA. Then what is this Z? Z andre eno? Z andre makla, Z represents the number of particles present in a lattice. Avondo lattice, cubic lattice alli eshtu particles present irutte annadanna navu Z na bardu represent martivi. Then what is this M? M indicates you the molecular mass or the atomic mass of that element you can consider or the metal you can consider athu the atomic mass na navu m bardu represent martivi then what is this na na andre as you all know that it was avogadro's constant agirutte and avogadro's constant has got a value that is constant value you can say that is 6.022 × 10²³ then what is this a from the previous questions you came to know that a is a edge length what is this formula I saying a cube anta helta ide and you came to know about all the datas here d is equal to Z into M divided by A cube into NA. This is the formula which is used for calculating the density of a crystal system. Now there is one problem regarding the density. Let us see the problem now. The problem is saying you that sodium metal in matter, it is crystallizes in a BCC structure. BCC structure ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲೈಸ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಯೂನಿಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಎಡ್ಜ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಅವರು ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 420 picometer then they are asking you to calculate the density na find out maadi anta heltidare they even provided you with the datas like the atomic mass of the sodium they have provided you that is 23 U okay and the Avogadro constant you know the value of it is 6.022 × 10²³ then you are going to apply those things given things in the formula As the formula says, D is equal to Z into M divided by A cube into NA. What is Z here? Z, direct aagi avaru nimge mention madilla. They are telling you that it is a BCC structure. BCC structure anta heltidare andre, the number of particles present in a BCC structure is 2. 2 particles illi present irutte. This is multiplication symbol, children. ಇಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಸಿಂಬಲ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಹ್ಯೂರ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಸಿಂಬಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಈಗ ಬಿಸಿಸಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಬಿಸಿಸಿ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟೂ. ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎಮ್? ಎಮ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ದ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್, ದೇ ಗೇವ್ ಯು ದ ಅಟಾಮಿಕ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ 23, ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ದೆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎನ್ ಎ? ಎನ್ ಎ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವೊಗಡ್ರೊ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ 6.022 × 10³. You are going to even apply that here. Then what is a cube? A is the edge length having the value 420 picometer, and you are going to apply that here. Before applying that, you need to convert the picometer. ಪೈಕೋಮೀಟರ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳ, ಅದನ್ನ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಂಟು ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್. ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ಗೆ ನೀವು ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಕನ್ವರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಪೈಕೋಮೀಟರ್ನ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ. 420 ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈಡ್ ಬೈ 10⁻¹. ಮೈನಸ್ 10 ಇಂದ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಮಾಡಿ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ದ ಡೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಸ್ಟಲ್ is found to be 1.031 gram per cm cube. This gram per cm cube is the unit for the density. Hope you got to know about how to solve a problem based on the density. Now let us move towards the last question, children. The last question, last important question of this chapter is, what are F centers? Mention their importance. If you consider F centers, the anionic sites occupied by the unpaired electrons. Iga makla, there is a crystal which contains both the cations as well as anions. Iga, for example, sodium chloride ne consider maartira anta ikkolli. Sodium chloride alli sodium anno cations kuda ide, chloride anno anions kuda ide. And here the anionic site alli chloride iro badlu enagutte, the unpaired electrons are going to occupy that center. When the unpaired electrons are going to occupy the anionic sites, they are called as F centers. Adanna navu F centers anta karitive. Then what is their importance? If you think of its importance, whenever there is a presence of unpaired electron, that unpaired electron has the capacity to impart a color to the crystal. Every crystal has got its characteristic color if it has got F centers, because they contain the unpaired electron. And you came to know about what are F centers and their importance. Hope you got to know regarding all the questions here, children. Here, if you consider, almost I have solved around 12 questions regarding the solid state chapter. Whatever the questions I have discussed today, all the questions are important questions. As I already told you that this chapter has got a weightage of around 7 marks. And if you study this much out of this chapter, definitely you can score around 5 to 6 marks out of 7. Thank you all for the session. We'll meet up in the next session. Thank you.